Well, meanwhile, there's been an extraordinary intervention by the New South Wales Energy Minister to ease the power panic across the state. Matt Kean has been given emergency powers to direct coal supplies into the energy grid. The electricity crisis taking the shine off the government's pre-budget bonanza.
Cash for cutting-edge science today, another curtain raiser in the pre-budget countdown. $270 million for new medical facilities at Camperdown and Westmead.
We want to see our best scientists turn their ideas into the next breakthrough technologies that could come up with a cure for cancer, for example, that could come up with the next vaccine.
Also getting a shot in the arm, the state's power supply, as focus quickly turned to the energy crisis.
AEMO advised me that we should activate some special powers to have on standby if in the event there was an unexpected change to the situation.
The government can now order coal producers to increase supply to electricity generators, but it doesn't think it will need to.
What this shows is the complete dysfunctionality of the current energy market.
The war in the Ukraine driving up the price of fossil fuels. At the same time, ageing coal-fired power stations are experiencing faults and becoming less reliable, while renewables are not ready to carry the load.
It shouldn't have come to this. How can we be one of the largest exporters of energy in the entire world, but we don't have enough to keep the lights on in Australia's largest state?
The state government says at the moment there's no need to ask people to conserve energy, and it's confident we're out of the difficult conditions that we saw earlier in the week.
We had a generator come online yesterday. That added 680 megawatts to the system.
Origin also urging people not to panic, but still use major appliances outside of peak times.
Not use the dishwasher. Turn off the dryer, all those things are going to help.
Matt Kean, though, says he'll keep the system running with everything in his power. Sarah Navin for 10 News First.